Are you looking to learn the basics of naming organic compounds using IUPAC name? Hi, I'm Dr. K and welcome to ChemSimplified. This is the second part of a two-part series in naming basic organic compounds. So if you're not familiar with this topic at all and you have not started naming any organic compounds at all, I strongly recommend that you please start with part one and then come back to this video. So I'll post the link on the top right corner. So in this video, we are going to focus on basic organic compounds. So that means all the compounds that we're going to name are going to be unbranched organic compounds. And we're going to use IUPAC in naming all of them. We'll go through naming the functional groups that is in the second and the third column. And that's starting with alcohol and all the way to amide. Coming into this video, you should already have the knowledge in naming alkane. So once you know how to name alkane, you can name a lot of compounds, and I'm going to prove it to you in this video. So we're going to start out with alcohol, and looking at our example, we need to first find the longest chain, and that's three carbons straight in a row. And we're going to number it from the end that is nearest to OH. So since in this example, our OH is smack right in the center, it actually doesn't matter if we start numbering from the left or from the right because OH will always happen to be on the second carbon in this example. So I'm just going to number it from the left. And then we name it as an alkane. So because there are three carbon, so three is P-R-O-P, prop. And then to indicate that it's an alkane, we end with the suffix A-N-E. So our name for this compound would be propane. But we're not done yet. So once we have named it as an alkane, what we need to do now is replace the E in alkane with the number N-O-L. So I'm going to demonstrate. So let's slash out the E, and then we're going to put in a number. So the number is where the OH is located. So in our example, OH is located on the second carbon. So we're going to put in 2. And then we need to put in O-L to indicate that it's an alcohol. So notice that in our name, propan-2-ol, there's a hyphen between the two, as in front of the two and after the two. And that is because whenever you have alphabets and number, they don't come in contact. They are separated by a hyphen or a dash. So make sure you keep that in mind whenever you name your organic compounds. So the next one is amine. The amine that we're going to focus in naming in this video is going to be the primary amine, which means nitrogen connected to two hydrogen and one carbon. So that is the simplest amine, and that's all we're going to focus on. So the first thing we need to do is find the longest chain, already found, four carbons straight in a row. And we need to start numbering from the nitrogen end. So in this case, we have starting from right to left. That's 1, 2, 3, 4. And then we name it as an alkane. So 4 is but, and to indicate it's alkane, we put A and E. So it's butane. And then, same thing like the previous example for alcohol, you take out the E in alkane and you remove it with amine. So we take out the E and then we put in amine. Because this is a primary amine, the nitrogen is always on carbon number 1. So we don't need to indicate the location of nitrogen. So clean up. This is our name, butanamine. Pretty simple, right? Now we're going to move on to the cousin of amine, which is amide. Amide, the difference between amide and amine is just the presence of C double bond O. So we're going to go through the same rules, and we start off with the longest chain, which is in this case 3 carbon, and we start numbering from the end that has C double bond O. So in our case, we're going to start numbering from the right. So now we're going to name it as an alkane. So 3 means propane. And same thing, take out the E and replace it with amide. So slash out the E, put in amide, clean it up, propanamide. That is the name for this compound. Okay, moving on, another example, aldehyde. So let's look at this. We're going to do the same way that we've been doing. So find the longest chain. Yes, 4 carbon, number from the end with C double bond O. So this is similar like amide. So now we're going to start numbering from the left to the right. And then we're going to name it as an alkane. So 4, so that's butane. And then we're going to slash out the E and we're going to replace it with Al. So butanal. That is the name of this compound. That's pretty easy, right? One word of caution, please don't confuse butanal with butanol. AL is to indicate aldehyde. OL is to indicate alcohol. Just thought you might want to pay attention to that. Okay, moving on to another C double bond O compound, ketone. So in this example, first thing we need to do is find the longest chain. So we have a continuous count of 6 carbon, and we're going to start numbering from the end that is closest to the C double bond O. So in our example, that's counting from the left-hand side, because C double bond O would be at carbon 3. If we count from the right-hand side, it would be at carbon 4. So always count from the end that is closest to C double bond O. And then we're going to name it as an alkene. So 6 means hex, and then put in A and E. So we have hexane. And then we're going to remove the E again, same thing. And now we're going to put in O and E. And we're going to indicate where our C double bond O is. O and E is to indicate that it's ketone. The number is to indicate where the C double bond O is at. So take out the E, and C double bond O is at carbon 3. So we're going to put a 3. And as usual, we need to separate alphabet and number using the dash, and then O and E. So clean it up, hexane 3-one. We're halfway there, let's move on to the next one. So we extend a little bit more to our ketone and we add in an OH, and that gives us a carboxylic acid. So this is an example of carboxylic acid, COOH. So same thing, find the longest chain, 3 carbons straight in a row. Start numbering from the end with COOH. So in carboxylic acid, COOH is always at the end. So all you have to do is just start numbering 1, where the carboxyl group is, and you'll be fine. And then name it as an alkane. Same thing. So 3, propane. Replace the E with OIC acid. So slash out the E, put in OIC acid, clean it up. Propanoic acid. We have started naming alcohol, amine, amide, aldehyde, and ketone. And all we've done is name them as an alkane, slash out the E, and replace it with the appropriate suffix. So now we're going to move on to something that is slightly different. I'll walk you through step by step, so don't worry. So now the second last example is ether. Ether is oxygen sandwiched between 2 carbons. What we're going to do with ether is that whenever you see that the compound that you're going to name is an ether, what you will do is you will divide the compound into 2 parts. And how you're going to decide how to divide them is that you find the part that is shorter and you include the oxygen and you call that part alkoxy. So in this case, this is the shorter part because we have oxygen. And to the left of the oxygen, there are 2 carbons. And to the right of the oxygen, there are 3 carbons. So obviously 2 is shorter than 3. So we're going to lump the 2 carbons along with the oxygen, and that's our shorter part. And for the rest of the compound, that's the longer part of the compound, we're going to name it as an alkane. So here's how we're going to do it. ETH to indicate there are 2 carbon in the shorter part. Once we have the prefix, which is ETH, we're going to put in OXY. And that is to name the shorter part that includes the oxygen. So that's ethoxy for our shorter part. And then for the longer part, we have 3 carbons. So prefix for 3 is prop. And then we're going to name it as if it's an alkane. So that's A and E. So that's prop in. Since these are all alphabets, we're going to stick them all together. So there's no space. So name for this compound is ethoxy propane. And lastly, which is, in my opinion, the most difficult one. Similar to our ether example just now, what we need to do is look at our ester and split it into 2 parts as well. You notice that you have the C double bond O and then OC, right? So we're going to group the carbons along with oxygen. Kind of like similar with what we did just now, except for we're not looking for the shorter part. We're just looking for oxygen and whatever that comes with it. So that whole thing, that's the part with the oxygen. That's our first part. The second part is the rest of the compound, which means C double bond O and whatever that comes along with it. So that's the part with C double bond O. So here are our 2 parts. So the first part is the part with oxygen. Let's go ahead and do that. So in this example, we have 2 carbons and therefore the prefix should be ETH. Put in YL, that is going to give us ethyl. So this is the blue part. And then we move on to the second part. So the rest of the compound is the part with the C double bond O. So what we're going to do is we're going to name it as if it's an alkane. And then after that, we're going to remove the E and replace it with O-A-T-E. So let's count. 1, 2, 3, 4. So don't forget to count the carbon with the C double bond O. And so because it's 4, so that's butane. And now we're going to slash out the E and replace it with O-A-T-E. So clean up the name, ethyl butanoate. So notice the difference between ester and ether is that even though everything is alphabet, we do separate out. So we have ethyl space butanoate. So that's the difference that you need to keep in mind in naming ether and ester. So I hope you find this helpful, and if at any point you need a refresher or you start getting confused, just jump to any part that you need to review. Go over it until you feel confident doing this. So here's the table that summarizes all the functional groups that we have already covered in this two-part series. So I hope you find this video helpful, and as usual, do subscribe and click on that bell icon so you get notified on new videos. Please head over to ChemSimplified. You will find blog posts related to this and some practice questions. Thanks for watching, and I'll see you in the next video.